On this company, they do it super real. They use legit actors. You're not going to know what's real and what's fake.
Bia and Charles Jaco. Charles, are you still hearing me? Charles
Jaco
is just...
Yes, the air raid sirens are just now going off here near these U.S. bases in Saudi Arabia. We've sent the entire camera crews inside right now. We're all preparing to put on our gas masks that we've been told. There are sounds of planes overhead. We don't know whose planes there are, but air raid sirens are going off insistently. There are military convoys on both sides of me. We're being told to get off this platform and get inside into the air raid shelter immediately. But right now, everyone's been training for this, and it looks like we may have to...
All right, Charles Jaco, that doesn't mean that he is in any imminent danger. Of course, we can't know that.
CD, if you need to take cover, I notice that you've got your gas mask in your hands. If you need to put it on, please do so. If you need to take cover.
People are looking up in the skies, scanning the skies to see what they can see. Hi, Atlanta. We're about to have a short course in missile identification. This is a Scud. You can tell it by its distinctive label. Now, when the missile is launched, the first thing you look for is the plume sticking out behind it. Now, when you detect this, you can tell it's been launched. Thank you.
See the graffiti on it? Yeah, show me graffiti.
Larry King, show or bust.
Je suis un journaliste américain.
Wolf.
Wolf.
Wolf. Oh, I love this country so much.
You guys just don't have a clue.
Well, Cheryl, it was almost exactly 2 hours ago when the sirens went off here in Saudi Arabia. Where we are in eastern Saudi Arabia, there was no problem. Now, let me just size my mask and fit it for a second, just like I always do. Stand by, please. All clear. They're... Oh, shh. What are they saying? Are they saying all clear?
Yes, ma'am. I can't hear.
Were they saying all clear down there just
I
now?
I cannot hear it.
All clear. All clear. Etabien was a false alarm. Got that, Atlanta? Standing down now. I'm gonna go get my hamburger and my coffee.
Good. We just got the all clear.
All clear. Every time I order something, this happens. All clear. Thank you. Go CNN reporting live from Saudi Arabia. Oh, I love this country so much.
You guys just don't have a clue.
Now, when you detect this, you can tell it's been launched. Thank you.
Boy, did I almost look stupid.
If you are able to take a question, did you think that the possible threat would be over because it is now morning there? It's what, just after 6 o'clock in the morning?
The whole thing is everyone assumed that the threat would be over because it was early morning. But the thing about Saddam Hussein is that he has never done the expected, and right now we have... All right, we are now led to understand that there are also firings in another city in Saudi Arabia. CNN's Carl Rochelle is here with me, just came up. Carl, I know we can't be very specific given these restrictions, but within those parameters, what did you see?
Well, what I saw, I didn't see anything hit. I looked very almost straight above us. There is a vapor trail coming from my right to my left, and there's a cloud of something. It looks like it might have been an explosion, a cloud. I'd say...
Putting on the gas mask. There hasn't been any gas dropped here, we can tell. You may smell some of the fumes from a missile exhaust going off. This was using a rocket at Fortnite.
I'll play this for a second. Have you seen this? I mean, this mother finds a fake Facebook ad. You know how they're selling all those masks now, I was telling you? They keep pumping them.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, you guys see them as well, obviously. On that. So this mother...
Yes.
8 years ago, the Ansich family took this professional photo for their holiday card. Last week, that same photo showed up in this ad. for a face mask, saying the entire family had died, except for the youngest son.
Who would have the audacity to clearly not know a family and type that they had died?
The ad goes on to say that the family went to a church service in the middle of this pandemic and contracted COVID-19.
It's on the forefront of everybody's mind and the news and everything and how quickly it is taking lives. It could so clearly be true to people.
Over the next couple of days, Sarah Ancich was inundated with Facebook messages from concerned family and friends.
And they were all, you know, reaching out saying, is this true? You know, you haven't posted anything in a while. Are you there? Are you okay?
She tried reporting the video to Facebook, but it kept popping up in her feed.
It was upsetting. It's violating.
Sarah says she hasn't posted the photo on social media in years. But if you do a reverse image search on Google, the photo is on several Pinterest boards for examples of family photos.
I don't know how I could have prevented this, or I would have.
In the video, the maker of the face mask, Filter Max, claims it's the most effective respirator on
the
market.
These people look so ridiculous.
And is FDA approved. Yay, and it's not. The ad also has video of a teenager identified as a member of the Ancich family, happily recounting his survival.
You know, and I'm curious about the boy in the video.
Okay, lady, the boy in the video is what people call a crisis actor. They do this for a living. Yeah, I mean, this is what's going on the whole time. I'll finish it up. There's only 30 seconds.
Where's he in this? Does he know that he's out there?
We reached out to Facebook and they immediately pulled down the ad, and there were several versions of it. Facebook also says in order to crack down on businesses taking advantage of fear during this pandemic, it has banned all ads having to do with hand sanitizer, face masks, wipes, and COVID-19 tests. Christine Lazar, KCAL 9.
Oh, this whole thing, you know, and the fakery, dude. I mean, if we talk about the fakery, we could stay here for like a week. Everything about it is fake. Everything. Trucks with the bodies, the places where they say they're taking people. There's some of them.
Ron Burgundy will read anything that is put on that teleprompter. And when I say anything, I mean
I am Fox San Antonio's Jessica Headley.
And I'm Ryan Wolf.
Our greatest responsibility is to serve our Treasure Valley communities.
The El Paso, Las Cruces communities.
Eastern Iowa communities.
Mid-Michigan communities.
We are extremely proud of the quality, balanced journalism that CBS 4 News produces.
But
we are concerned about troublemaking and irresponsible one-sided news stories plaguing our country.
The sharing of biased and false news has become all too common on social media. More alarming, some media outlets publish these same fake stories without checking facts first.
The sharing of biased and false
news has become all too common on social media.
More alarming, some media outlets publish these stories without checking facts first. Unfortunately, some members of the media use their platforms to push their own personal bias and agenda to control exactly what people think, and this is extremely dangerous to our democracy.
This is extremely dangerous to our democracy.
Don't worry, be happy.
Let me tell you, when you go recall, you get nothing but first-class memories. Private cabin on the shuttle, deluxe suite at the Hilton, plus all the major sites, Mount Pyramid, the Grand Canals, and of course, Venusville.
Yeah, but how real does it seem?
As real as any memory in your head.
Come on, don't bullshit me.
No, I'm telling you, Doug, your brain will not know the difference. And that's guaranteed, or your money back.
We're entering an era in which our enemies can make it look like anyone is saying anything at any point in time, even if they would never say those things. So, For instance, they could have me say things like, I don't know, Killmonger was right, or Ben Carson is in the sunken place, or how about this, simply, President Trump is a total and complete dipshit. Now, you see, I would never say these things, at least not in a public address, but someone else would. Someone like Jordan Peele. This is a dangerous time. Moving forward, we need to be more vigilant with what we trust from the internet.
Brothers and sisters, this is quite alarming, to say the least. This is so alarming. I warned about this several months ago when I heard that there was a college that was in the process of developing technology to copy somebody's voice and be able to use their voice to say anything they wanted to say. And I says it won't be long before they'll be able to do that with a video or picture. And lo and behold, they now have the technology. Did you hear what I said? They now have the technology. Samsung deep fake. And I'm sure this goes along with deep mind. This is AI. Okay? Samsung deep fake AI could fabricate a video of you from a single profile pic. Just from a picture of you. You can only imagine where this can go. Here's Mona Lisa. Just the picture of Mona Lisa, and they were able to do this. Let me zoom in a little bit here. Now, just by using the picture, this is what they've been able to do on the left-hand side. Add some voice to that. Now, what if that was somebody that's a real person? They could make anybody say anything they want them to say. And could they get to the point to where people won't be able to tell the difference between that which is real and that which is not real?
The real issue here is this. Is the scene that we saw on tape an act, or was it for real?
Thank you.
know, and they just start making stuff up.
Yeah.
Like that Neil Armstrong guy. Have you seen him on the talk shows?
Neil Armstrong, you mean the first man to walk on the moon?
Talk about a fish story.
Yeah.
Man, and they're buying it.
Oh, Yeah.
And they just start making stuff up.
Yeah.
Like that Neil Armstrong guy. Have you seen him on the talk shows?
Neil Armstrong, you mean the first man to walk on the moon?
Talk about a fish story.
Yeah.
Man, and they're buying it.
Oh, yeah.
Good morning, I'm Kent Shocknick, and Space Shuttle Challenger is just a few seconds away from blasting off from the Kennedy Space Center near Cape Canaveral, Florida. Let's take a look right now.
7, 6, we have main engine start, 4, 3, 2, 1, and liftoff. Lift
solid rocket boosters kicking in.
The space shuttle mission, and it has cleared the tower.
This shuttle mission will launch. My God.
1:15.
There's been an explosion.
Velocity 2,900 feet per second. Altitude 9 nautical miles. Downrange distance 7 nautical miles.
This is not standard. This is not something that is planned, of course. I can see a solid rocket booster has broken away from Shuttle Challenger. That's what you're looking at in the middle of your screen. I cannot see the shuttle itself.
In 1986, the Shuttle Challenger exploded about 74 seconds after takeoff, killing all 7 astronauts inside. Or did it? It turns out that 6 of the 7 are still alive and kicking today. Ellison Onizuka claims to be his identical twin brother, Claude. Yeah. I've got identical twin brother Claude too. The Challenger pilot, Mickey Smith, hasn't even bothered changing his name. He's now Professor Michael J. Smith of University of Wisconsin. Now, Krista McAuliffe was a bit of a sneaky one. She was the Challenger payload specialist, quite famous for being a teacher. It turns out during her astronaut days she was using her middle name, Krista. And now she goes by her first name, Sharon, and she's a Syracuse law professor. The Challenger commander, Francis Richard Scobie, is now Dick Scobie, which sounds like a rather unpleasant disease, CEO of Cows in Trees Limited. Judith Resnick, the Challenger mission specialist, again hasn't even bothered changing her name. She's a professor at Yale Law. And finally, Ronald McNair, another Challenger mission specialist, claims to be his identical twin brother, Carl McNair. What are the odds?
Part of the team, even though she was not a trained astronaut.
She knows where we're going to be standing, how busy it's going to be, where she can help, where we need our space. And she has learned an awful lot and become a team
weird member. Lady with scale and swords and blindfolds, or Grecian goddess, or warrior princess, or whatever it is. What makes it legible? And so one of the questions in the book is to puzzle about both its history and the legibility of this, which is a marker, and of course this local